There were over 100 million prescriptions written for Synthroid or generic levothyroxine in 2017, which is why I wanted to make this video for anyone who still has doubts or questions on how it should be best taken and when it should be taken. I'm confident that by the end of this video, you'll also feel confident too in how to take Synthroid, how it is best absorbed, and how you can make sure you stay healthy while you're on this therapy. Synthroid is used to treat hypothyroidism, which is when your thyroid doesn't produce enough thyroid hormone on its own to meet the needs of your body. The thyroid is a small butterfly-shaped gland that sits at the front of your neck, and it releases hormones like T4 and T3 to help your body regulate and use energy. In fact, it controls functions like how your heart beats and how your digestive system works, so it has an important role for sure, but sometimes it doesn't produce enough of these hormones to carry out important functions and can lead to symptoms like fatigue, weight gain, slower heart rate, muscle weakness, dry and thinning hair, feeling more sensitive to the cold, and a lot more. So doctors prescribe Synthroid or its generic levothyroxine, a synthetic version of the hormone T4, as a solution to help restore and return your thyroid hormones to normal. The difference between the two is how well your body is going to respond and absorb either of them. The American Thyroid Association recommends remaining to the one that was initially prescribed for the course of your therapy. And the best way to take it, unless if you're told otherwise by your doctor, is number one, if you don't take any other medications in the morning, it's best to take it when you first wake up on an empty stomach, 30 to 60 minutes before your first meal, or caffeinated beverage with a full glass of water. Some studies show that food decreases absorption of levothyroxine by 20%, so that's why we take it on an empty stomach. Number two, we also say to take it in the morning because for some people, they found it hard to fall asleep after taking it because of the cross relationship it has with the adrenal hormone called cortisol, which keeps you up and alert, and the hypothalamus, the pituitary axis, which regulates all the hormones in your body, and that includes TSH or thyroid stimulating hormone. Number three, if you take iron, calcium, or antacids like Tums, separate them about 4 hours after taking Synthroid because they will decrease absorption of the Synthroid as well. Number four, if you are pregnant, thinking of becoming pregnant, or breastfeeding, let your doctor know because your dose of Synthroid may need to be increased. Number five, keep in mind, when you first start taking it, it may take several weeks for you to see improvements in symptoms, so don't discontinue it if you find no relief of symptoms just yet. By week six, your doctor should want to see you again to test your thyroid levels again at that point and see if any adjustments are necessary to be made. Then they'll go from there to check your levels at least once a year afterwards. Number six, Synthroid interacts with a lot of medications, so let your doctor know what you're taking at all times, especially if you are planning to start anything new. Foods like soybean, flour, cottonseed meal, walnuts, and dietary fiber may cause your body to absorb less Synthroid, and seaweeds like kelp should definitely be avoided as there are high levels of iodine, which can make both hypo and hyperthyroidism worse.
You gotta be kidding me.
And lastly, because Synthroid can make you lose weight, which for a lot of us seems nice, it should never be used for that reason, as it can put you at risk for a dangerous heart rate abnormality and risk for bone fractures if you take more than what you are supposed to be taking, that is. So always stick to what your doctor has ordered for how you should be taking it. If you or a loved one are taking Synthroid, send them over this video as a refresher course to their therapy. If you like the video, give it a like as it helps me out tremendously, and subscribe to not miss out on more videos just like these. And as always, see you on the next one.